currently in Zanzibar Island, Tanzania, or the natives say Tanzania, Africa. Yes, you heard right. Your girl is in the motherland. I haven't wanted to come here for such a long time. I have been yearning and fiending to come to Africa, and here I am. Got in yesterday. I will drop snippets of that into this vlog. So let's rewind it back. Mom, get this on camera. That's so cute. I can't even see it. Look, hold on. Maku, that is so cute. Thank you. So funny.
What?
This is my YouTube channel.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, sorry.
Hakuna Matata. Welcome to the paradise under the sun.
Thank y'all. It was a total of 17 hours. I flew 12 hours into Dubai and then caught a 5-hour flight from Dubai here. So total of 17. So between 13. I know, I'm exhausted.
Welcome to your new home.
Thank you.
Everyone is going to her room. Oh,
that's bad luck.
Wait a minute.
Something might be wrong.
There goes Miss Randolph. Opening her door.
There goes.
Hooray.
Welcome to your new home. Can you use this, please? Put it inside. Put it inside.
Oh, yeah. I put it inside?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Then switch on the lights.
Oh. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
That's
welcome.
So cute.
You love your room?
Yes, yeah, this is different.
It's beautiful. Oh, very sorry.
Alright y'all, so I am pressed for time right now, but this is my room where I'm currently staying, my little porch area, and let's go to breakfast now because I got to go. In the meantime, I'm gonna give y'all views. I don't even want to do too much talking. I'll talk later. Y'all enjoy the view. Okay. Hi, good morning. Hi, good morning. Yeah, I'm doing good. Are you having breakfast right here?
Breakfast,
yes. Okay.
Room number, please.
52.
52. You're welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I have
good ones. You might be friend with me.
Hi, good morning. Have you on my vlog for YouTube. So this is Kareem, y'all. I met him last night.
Hello.
Go ahead, introduce a little of who
name
you are.
My Kareem. I'm made in Zanzibar. And you're called Kadeem Sama.
Oh, wait. Is that what you told me?
Yeah, you said
Okay, say it again.
Kadeem Sama.
Okay, so.
Asante.
Asante.
Kadeem, and you say Asante.
Asante.
Yes. There you go.
I'm trying to learn, y'all. I'm trying to learn. There you go. My host just hit me up and said he's here. And I'm like, dang, he was literally on time. It's at 8 o'clock, and he's here at 8. Really quickly. All right. Hi, I just come in here and just grab whatever. Okay. Thank you. Okay, thank you.
The food is really good, y'all. Really good. I got this drink. I forgot what it's called. I'm about to try it. Oh no. It has like a taste. I can't quite put my finger on it, but I am familiar with it. To me, so I can feed it, but the little girl at the table in front of me is already feeding the cat. Sad face. But at least the cat is being fed. But I want the cat to come with me. Very good.
The cat is coming to me, y'all.
Let me see what I can get, kitty.
Later. Excursions. He picked me up yesterday from the airport. That's who y'all saw. And he's gonna be my host with me the entire duration of this trip. His name is Mop, and I was introduced to him by this young, lovely young lady that I went to college with. Her aunt came here last November, I want to say. Her name is Letitia. Shout out to Letitia. And I'm gonna go this way. Well, they came here and I hit her up like, yo, I've been wanting to come to Zanzibar. I want to come someplace for my 30th birthday. I really want to go to Africa for my 30th birthday. I've been saving since I was 27, so for the past 3 years, because I knew I wanted to come here to Africa in general. I didn't know exactly where at the time, but I had a few places on my list, and this place was one of them. And she put me in contact with Maku, who was her host for her and her aunts, and I felt really comfortable because her and her aunts are very black bougie. So the review she gave him, I trust wholeheartedly her thoughts and opinions, because I already know how she rolls. They do not play in her family at all. So I've been talking to him for about a year now, like WhatsApp, just checking in, looking at his Instagram page, seeing like what he's doing and how he like operates and moves, and just building that rapport. So when the time came for me to come and start booking things, I felt very comfortable with having him as being the one that I'm gonna be with, since this is my first solo trip. For those that I didn't even tell y'all, I can't even say those that don't know, because there are some people that don't know, which is y'all, but like my peers, family, everybody knows I'm here alone. But so far, so good. Hi, good morning. Really nice.
The beach people, it's, they're so good.
Yes, it's beautiful. They're very friendly.
Yeah.
The food is, I learned Asante.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, Asante. Thank you, pole pole. Slowly, slowly.
Slowly.
Yeah, pole.
Pole, pole.
Yeah, pole, pole.
Then that means slowly.
Slowly, yeah.
So, in what way do I need to use that?
Pole, pole, when we want to do something, yeah?
Uh-huh.
In Swahili or in Zanzibar, almost we do pole, pole.
Pole, pole.
Pole, pole. So, pole. For you, for the English, we call slowly.
Slowly, okay.
So for the 5 minutes, we do 10 minutes. Okay. That's why we call it pole pole.
Okay.
All
ready?
Hakuna Matata.
Hakuna Matata. Come on, let's go. Bill Gates.
Yeah, Bill Gates. You know Bill Gates?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the island of
Gates. He owns that?
Yes.
What?
The hotel inside.
Inside the island?
Yeah, it's too expensive.
Of course it is. Yeah. Beautiful.
Nice.
Those are dory. Have you ever seen Finding Nemo? That's the dory fish.
You can swim with them, sorry. Take a million of pictures. Yeah.
Wow.
Oh. That is gorgeous.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm just here.
So this is a really, really full.
Oh wow, okay.
You eat a Coca-Cola Zero. Yeah, it's nice to drink.
Normally I don't like coconut water, but this is really good.
But you have to eat a coconut, uh-huh. See, this one. And you can put the this one. You see?
With the pineapple.
So when you eat together, you will get something. Yeah, try it.
Okay.
This is plain. Mango plain.
Okay.
Last time, take this. Try it.
Okay, a red banana. So I just peel it?
Yeah, a red banana, the taste is different. Red is very sweet. The color outside is the difference, and the taste also is different. But inside it is the same.
It's good.
Yeah.
I think I actually like it better than a regular yellow banana. It's that good.
This is my favorite one.
Mm. Okay, so that's how you eat passion fruit.
Sorry?
So that's how you eat passion fruit?
Yeah, that's time is for passion fruit.
Let me try the little baby one first. Every time like I hear passion fruit now, I just think of Drake. That's all. Jeez. Passion fruit by Drake. Alexa, play Drake passion fruit. All right, thank you. So this is like a beach?
Yeah.
In the middle of the ocean.
So this is it.
The sand dollar and the sea urchin. That is a huge starfish.
Yeah.
Oh wow. That is so neat. And it's kind of creepy. But it's going to dry out if it stays on the beach, correct?
Yeah, that's why I need to take him to go to the water.
Oh, wow. I've only seen them when they're dead. I've never seen one alive and moving. It almost reminds me of a snake. That is gorgeous. We are currently on a dolphin hunt right now. I think I just saw one. So all these boats full of people are trying to find the dolphin. Building a house right here.
Fresh.
Hello. He's my brother.
Hi.
From another mother.
How are you?
I'm doing good. What's your name?
My name is Omi. What's yours?
Omi.
Omi Zenzi. Yeah.
Zenzi, nice to meet you.
How long has the sea turtles been here?
The sea turtles, oh, they have been here for a long time because they are rescue turtles. So they have been here for 7 months because they have to be here until they recover their injury. Once they recover, that's how we have to take them back.
Okay.
Yeah, but normally it's depending with their injury. If the injury will be, if you take a long time for them to be in here, so they also have to be here for a long time. If it will take if it will be recovered for the short times, like for the few days, that's how they have to be taken. But they normally we do like the 20th of February, that is how to be a turtle released. Because they also have to go back for laying the baby turtles.
Yeah.
So we have to take them on the 10th of February.
Oh, okay. Thank you so much for all your information.
Thank you too.
Yeah.
Yeah, so this is an Africa rock python. So they are original from here. So we have so many of them in this island. But this is type of a snake. They are not poison. So they like people as well. And people used to hold them in their arms on the neck, something like that. And what they eat, it's a rat and chicken sometimes as well. But in here, we have to give them a rat. But they would like to eat something which is moving. So if you give the rat, the die rat, they cannot eat. They would like to get something which is moving. So that's why we have to give them the alive things, because they want to chasing it and grab some and eat it. So four of them, they are there.
That's four of them?
Yeah.
And how old is the oldest?
The oldest one is only 20 because they are still a baby.
Oh.
These one are baby. They are about 3.5 meters. but they can be up to 7.5 meters.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so they are still baby.
So they're still gonna grow.
Yes, they will.
Wow. All right, hello everyone, welcome back. Y'all, wasn't that an amazing day? I wanted to do a quick room tour. So, not huge room, it's more like a little studio apartment. I'm opening up my windows right now. All right, so MTV room style. Let me open up the door. Hi. I did this on my own. Hi MTV, my name is Zinzi and welcome to my African Zanzibar Island crib. Come on in. All right, everyone. So this is my room. I just got back, so don't pay attention to that bag. This is my, so when you walk in, you see like my little table, my mini fridge, my just little desk. Coffee, pot, phone, TV. When I first migrated over here from the U.S., the person who picked me up from the airport had this printed for me so that I would know who was going to assist me in my move over here to Africa. So right here is my bed. It's a canopy bed. One nightstand, another nightstand over here. The windows. First of all, y'all, let me tell you about these windows real quick. They're gonna be open for now, but they're not gonna be open. And the reason why the bed has a canopy is because of the bugs. I didn't know that initially with me getting an African traditional style place, that when you see a canopy or something like that, there could be some bugs. Yes, there was some little gnats and some ants in the bathroom. So we're gonna come up here. This is like my little closet area. As you can see, I'm still moving in, so just got those two bags. My other bag should be arriving later on next week. Right here is my bathroom, my window, shower, and the shower's just like this, so there is no curtain and it doesn't, there's, it's not movable. So this is it. Nice shower head and the door. And yeah, this is it. This is all she wrote right here, all she wrote. And y'all already know my little porch area. All right, MTV, thank you so much for coming to my crib. All right, all right. So y'all don't have to go home, but y'all got to get the hex up out of here, okay? Don't let the doorknob hit you with the good. Don't let the doorknob hit you. Don't let the doorknob hit you with the good Lord split you. You know how you say that? Mm-hmm. We just gonna roll with that. All right, bye. Thank you.
This is for food and for drink.
Thank you. Thank you, Kareem.
This is the flies. This one, coconut crescent, tiger prawns.
Uh-huh.
And this one, we call it calamari barbecue with the grill and the warm salad.
Okay. What is this green sauce?
Oh, this is like the correction sauce, but it's nice.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
You're welcome. Boy.
This right here is not fried shrimp. It's fried prawns. The difference is that these are bigger than shrimp. That's the difference. Oh, caribou. So I just learned, okay, wait, don't tell me. Asante.
Yes.
What else did I learn? Wait. Uh-huh. It means slowly. Is it palong?
Yes. Palong. Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yeah, that's it.
Slowly.
Pale, pale.
Okay, I just said palong, palong.
Pale, pale.
Pale, pale.
Yeah, that's
okay, good. I learned that one.
Yeah.
And okay, so what did you just say? I'm going to try to learn that one.
Caribou.
Karibu.
Yeah, that's Karibu.
And that means welcome.
Yes.
Karibu.
Yeah.
Okay. And so all of this is Swahili.
Yeah, okay. This is Swahili because in Tanzania we got like 124 languages.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
124 languages?
Yes, yes. And 125, but 24, that's different language. And one language that we speak all of us, that's our national language.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, Duchapel, man.
What's up?
What's up? Hey, everyone. So it is Friday night. I am about to go like an hour away into town called Stone Town, and I'm going to the club. This girl that who put me in contact, Letitia, I should say her, this girl, because I told y'all about her earlier. So Letitia, when she put me in contact with Maku, this lighting in this room doesn't have the best lighting, but she told me that he took her to a club one night and she said it was the best time she had pretty much in her life. So I'm like, okay. That's a lot to say. That's a mouthful. So when I came here, I told Maku, hey, the club that Letitia went to, I want to go. So he said, well, the best day is Friday. He said, the club is going on any day of the week, but Friday is the best. And he said, the club don't close until like 7 a.m. So I'm like, oh, well, let me nap then. Since I know I don't have to rush because the club ain't closing at 2 a.m. And I just got some clear sandals on my feet, flats, because I'm not going to put on no heels out here. That's a no-no. But, yeah. All right, so I'm going to put my vlog camera away until the morning, and I will be recording any interesting footage on my cellular phone, and I'll be inserting it into the vlog. Anyway, y'all have a good night. Bye.
Then our mouth is not aggressive, no biting, not stealing, cool, friendly. Hakuna matata monkey like me. But according to our regulation, if you touch the monkey, $300 fine. But if monkey touch you, free of charge. Picture, video, selfie with a monkey you can enjoy. And sometimes baby monkey can jump on your shoulder. Don't be afraid, don't shout, and don't take your hand to remove the monkey. You can pound your phone if chance for selfie. After 1, 2, 3 seconds, monkey will go away. Okay? They allowed to touch us, but we are allowed to touch them.
Give me 5. Give me 5.
Give me better 5. 0.5 to give it.
Hello everybody, today is Saturday, October the 28th. I am currently in the van and we are going to the mangrove.
Hakuna Matata.
Hakuna Matata. This is Maku, as y'all know, some of y'all know. But yeah, so as y'all just saw, I was in the forest seeing the red monkeys. What was the other monkeys?
Sorry?
Were they all red monkeys? No, that's the red monkey. What about the black and white one?
We have a black and we have a red one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
A red one never seen in the world except in Zanzibar. Yeah, because the color is red. And they are so friendly. They just come in close and then they say hi to you.
They were chilling.
Yeah.
And they looked like it was nap time for them. They weren't even really paying us no mind as people. Wanted the monkeys that would jump on your shoulder that you could hold a pet. They were like All right, I'll let y'all get a few pictures and videos, and then we signing out on to the next branch. What's here? So tell me where we're going and what's special about the mangrove.
Mangrove is from the ocean. So while we go there, first we can see the little bit, and then we can get a chance to see the crab. After that, we will see the little bit fruit from the mangrove also. So.
Nice.
Got you on my vlog camera, Abraham. Go ahead and introduce yourself.
My name is Ibrahim. I am 5 years old. I am Barian. And you are welcome. It's Zanzibar. Karibuni sana. Hakuna matata, Zanzibar.
Hakuna matata. Good. I have a booking. Okay.
Take the table number 4 there.
Can I sit outside?
You can sit outside.
Thank you.
I did the passion mojito with white rum, Bacardi, passion juice, lime, sugar a little bit, and passion and one.
So this is the crab ravioli.
Here's this.
Asante.
Instagram or I am YouTube.
All of it. Here, I'll show it to you. Okay, stop that joint. Hold on, let me get my color together. Okay, there we go. Go ahead and introduce yourself.
Hi, my name is Preska. I'm a doctor from Ghana.
Yes, and Preska is also a solo traveler.
Yes, I am.
First trip?
First trip solo.
Just like me?
Just like you.
What encouraged you to...
So I came out of a long-term relationship last year. And I'm trying to get used to traveling alone. I don't have to depend on someone to travel.
Yeah.
Get used to traveling by myself.
Mm-hmm.
So far, so good.
Yeah.
Yeah, so good.
And going against the grain and going against the fears that people project on you.
I was so scared.
Like, be careful.
Be careful.
You know?
My mom asks for my location every 5 seconds. Where are you? Send location. Where are you? But it's good.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's good.
Very peaceful.
Very. Yeah. It's so beautiful.
And it's also something that empowers you too.
Yes, I'm very empowered. So now, you know, before I was used to going on vacations with my boyfriend. And then after the breakup, I'm like, what am I going to do? Because I got used to that. It was a long-term, 5-year relationship.
Oh.
Yeah. But... Yeah, but living.
Yes, and being beautiful while living.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
Seeing the coconuts.
Ooh,
yes,
thank you.
Thank you. Enjoy.
Thank you, Asante.
That's what it is, it's ice cream. I think with cinnamon.
Uh-huh.
Yes, you guys are rude.
Excuse me. Excuse me.
Oh, I don't like it. Moment. Thank you.
Wow. That quick. Yeah, as y'all can see, when I first walked up here, didn't have any water down here. And now it is truly a restaurant in the middle of the ocean. Yes. Let me tell y'all something. This African sun is no joke. This no joke. I've never been in the sun like this. Not even, and I think Dubai was the sun bearing on my face the way it does here in Africa. Sheesh.
Hakuna Matata.
I remember earlier today when we went to the mangrove. Well, this is it. I'm going through the mangrove right now. It's pretty cool, but it's definitely giving me the movie Anaconda. Have y'all ever seen that movie? It's giving Anaconda vibes. But I know earlier our tour guide told us that there are no snakes, there are no mosquitoes, there are no crocodiles, there are no spiders. No spiders. I had to think about that one. So he said it's safe water.
But yeah, still, it's giving that. That was it's giving Anaconda. Beach. I hope y'all can hear me through the music. And I was told y'all that this beach is private, but it doesn't look that private to me, especially when you see all the people. No. I think of private beach, I think of 50, 100, it's hundreds of people out here. All right. Oh, and there's a lot of dogs. I wonder where all these dogs come from. Not that I have an issue, because I love the animals, but still. All right, let's party. So, which one are we in? Yeah. This one? Thank you.
Gentlemen,
Sonia, ¿qué?
Yeah, Elandi. Elandi is a big antelope.
Oh,
like okay. Impala, but this is a big. And also difference between Elandi and Impala. Elandi male and female have horns. But for Impala, only male. Male have horns, but female have no horns.
Okay.
Male
dann hast du es, dann hast du Pech gehabt. Du kannst hier nicht durch die ganze Raum fliegen. Jetzt zum fünften Mal. Ja. Ich verstehe halt nicht, warum ich mich immer wieder.
For lunch. Y'all wanna know something kind of embarrassing? I feel like so far we've seen all the animals that we're probably gonna see. I know a lot of us really want to see a lion, but our tour guide says lions are nocturnal, and a lot of times they don't even come out at night, which is weird because I feel like anytime I watch like Animal Planet, I always see lions in the daytime, so I don't understand. But we haven't seen a lion. He keeps saying you may not
But they do alert them. Sorry, my camera. But they do alert them. But y'all, when I tell y'all I only got 30 minutes of sleep, because I had to wake up early, do my makeup, and be with Maku at 5 a.m. to come here. Only 30 minutes, because yesterday we did a lot. By the time I got home, went back to the hotel, I couldn't really sleep. I just knew, like, okay, my mind was just on go. I was like, all right, well, Monday I'm going to a new hotel, so let me start gathering my things, listening to music, and y'all, time just flew. The last time I looked at the clock, it was 2:35 in the morning, and next thing you know, I was like waking up, and it was like 3:15. Yeah. So y'all, guess what? I surely did fall asleep in this little Jeep. It was comfortable too, and I ain't mad at it, cause I knew I won't miss out on anything. But I was like, dang, like I need some rest. But I'm gonna eat and then I'm gonna stay up on this point, cause I don't wanna miss too much. You know, this is an experience. But I was up for the first part, for the very first, and then mid first or whatever, I fell asleep, and then that was it. Like, no. But I was up for the first part, But I did need rest, clearly, as y'all can hear. Y'all, so I just got done eating. Y'all, when I told y'all, they said that that the monkeys or that the baboons just know to take stuff out your car. You know, I was like, that sounds believable, but I was like, huh? Talk to you. Hello. How are you? I'm well. Thank you. Right there, uh-huh. You know he up to no good. He sure is. Before we ate lunch, they told us to make sure we grabbed our stuff out the Jeep, because the baboon is known to go up in people's cars and steal their stuff. And I was wondering how believable that was until... Look at it. Look at that. I was wondering how real it was when he said they're known to take stuff out your car, but the proof is in the pudding. This is the proof right here. Look. You could tell he looks like he's searching too. And now look, y'all, the bamboo done migrated to a whole nother vehicle. Mm-hmm. And look, they're trying to hide like we didn't already catch them. Red-handed.
Yeah, some Yemen, right?
No.
It's a boy, Papa. It's a boy, Papa.
And that all is gone.
Wow, look at the eyes of the python.
Y'all, so I just got off the little jet plane. I'm back at the Zanzibar airport. I'll be heading back to the hotel. And then tomorrow, Monday, I switch to a different hotel in the city of Stone Town.
Yo, good Monday, October 31st morning. Is today the 31st? It is. I am currently checked out this hotel, Kindu Rocks. I finally know how to say it. So I'm currently checked out the hotel. I'm about to go to Stone Town, which is the city part of Zanzibar, and check into my new hotel. Decided to have two different stays while I was here, just so I could get two different types of experiences. So this one was like the beach experience, and then the next place that I stay at will be more of the city with the beach experience. So y'all, I have Abraham here. I told him that I wanted to take like a picture down here before we leave. Yeah, that's what he's about to do. You saw that? I almost missed the stuff. Okay, so like right here. Hi. Oh. No, I really appreciate you, Abraham, and all that you've done for me this entire time. You are such a pleasure to be around, and such a beautiful, soft spirit, gentle spirit, too.
I really appreciate you. I can say more than you appreciate me.
Yeah. Yeah.
It was cool and charming.
Yeah. Thank you.
I really like the way you are. Yeah.
No, thank you. Don't make me cry. It's not my last day yet.
Okay.
All right, y'all. So I am about to go on the spice tour. You lead the way, I'll follow you.
And I will be with my assistant, guide.
Okay.
Guide.
Okay.
So I will give you some spice to smell.
Thank you.
And to taste.
Okay.
We have like a game. Guessing game.
Okay.
Yes, I'll give you some spice to smell.
Yes.
And that's most guessing. They got been a ton of.
Okay. Oh, I got it. Guess the smell.
Guessing game. Let's stop over here.
Okay.
Can you guess maybe this one?
Okay.
He will give you. Let me give you. The photo I really need to. Look at them. Smell and tell. Can you guess it, maybe? So this spice from this tree, It is look like as a black seed.
Okay. Oh, like black seed oil. They make oil.
Oh. We don't make oil. We put in our dishes black seed or black quince.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Do you know?
No.
Black and very strong, like a chili.
Oh, okay. But I've never seen that before. I just only know black seed oil.
Ah, black seed oil.
Yes. I don't think I'm going to be good at this game, y'all.
You know this one. After harvesting, We dry it on the sun and it becomes black. Do you know?
No, I've never seen this before.
Don't you know black pepper?
Yes, black. Oh, okay. So
this is a black pepper.
Can I get that?
Well, black pepper starting with green color.
Uh-huh.
After green color, it's changing a color and it becomes red color. After that, we harvest it, we dry it on the sun, and it becomes a black.
Okay, I need to take pictures of this.
Yeah.
I didn't know it started out green.
It's green, after green, ready. After ready, we harvest it, dry it on the sun, and it becomes a black. Mm. In part of red pepper, we harvest the pepper where it is red color. After that, we remove red skin and we get empty paper. We put on hot water. Then we dry it on the sun and it become white.
Oh, okay.
So paper is good for asthma. Do you know asthma?
Mm-hmm.
So it's good for asthma. If you cannot breathe, you can find a paper, black one, mixed with the powder, then you can drink 1 spoon or 2 spoon. Then it is topping. And also paper is good for the dishes. You can put on pilau rice, soups. Do you use a paper?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
In which is this, which you use this?
For food.
For food, exactly.
Oh, that's vanilla?
So the vanilla. Vanilla is starting with green color, green beans. After 1 month, it changing a color and become yellow beans. After becoming yellow beans, we harvest it, we dry it on the room and become a black. Vanilla is the second expensive spice in the world. The first expensive is the saffron.
Is it what?
Saffron. Do you know saffron?
Mm-mm.
Don't you know saffron? Like it has the orange color? Saffron. I will show you.
Okay.
Saffron. You know this one?
Yes. My favorite. Aloe.
Aloe?
Yes.
And how you use aloe?
Everywhere. Mm-hmm. But it's good for sunburn. Mm-hmm. So it's good for hair. Mm-hmm. It's like a natural conditioner for your scalp and your ends and all this stuff. It's good for, it's a healing plant. That's how my mother introduced it to me as a child. She said, if you get a scar or a cut, put aloe on and it'll help it to heal. So yeah.
So even as it is very nice while using the same of you, it is good for hair.
Mm-hmm.
We make like a cream for the face.
Mm-hmm.
It is good for the sunburn.
Yeah.
And also it is good for stomach pain. If you're feeling a pain for the stomach, like
you can eat it.
You can take the piece, cut in a small piece, put on bottom, which has the water.
Mm-hmm.
Or if you don't have, you can boil it.
Mm-hmm.
At the boil, you can drink the water. It is very, very bitter. But it is good for the stomach.
Didn't know that. Thank you.
It is very nice.
I will do that. So a lot of Americans deal with high blood pressure.
Mm-hmm.
So now I know to get some lemongrass, to boil some lemongrass for high blood pressure. Because a lot of people take medicine because their blood pressure is so high.
It's not good to use the medicine. That's much the natural one. So take a lemongrass, boil, drinks every day before eating anything.
Okay.
During the morning times, it is gone. It will become standard. I like lemongrass tea, but my pressure is very, very low. That's why I stop it.
Okay. And a lot of Americans deal with stress, too. So.
This is how pineapple is. One plant of pineapple is only one fruit of pineapple. It is very, very rare to see two. It's only one. So when you harvest this pineapple, that's must to cut like this. They call it songololo, centipede, millipede. So this one.
That's
it is very good to making a soup.
Ew.
Yes.
Y'all make centipede soup?
We cut in small pieces. You boil. It is good for soup. Don't you like or you like it?
Okay. Well, I'm here to try it all.
We have got lipstick.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you'll see the men. They put on the lips like this.
Uh-huh.
This is how our grandmom, they was used long time ago.
And how to use the get lipstick long time ago.
But now we have so many lipstick. We are using this one. It's like the natural ones. We put things a lot in our dishes.
Okay.
We put on curry powder to make curry become red color.
Mm-hmm.
We put on tandoori masala and we put on paprika.
Oh.
Just for food coloring.
Okay.
Yes. Open it. It is opening automatic. And this is how banana starting with small flowers.
Oh.
So this is small flowers and this is becoming a banana like this.
Yes. But it just starts out that small.
Yes. So you can boil banana, you can fry it. Sometimes you can mix with your coconut milk.
Cinnamon is a menthol?
Exactly.
Oh.
Almost of the guests, they are so surprised.
What? Who would have known? So when you're sick, especially when I was a child and I couldn't breathe, my nose would be stuffy. My mom used to rub like the menthol like down here underneath so I can help open up the breathe. That's what this is. But the root of that is cinnamon.
Exactly. So this is the root of the cinnamon. We are making a Vicks.
Okay.
And Vicks, it is very, very nice, as you say, for flu,
headache,
chest rubbing. And also, during the corona times, we was collecting a lot of the cinnamon roots. We boil, then we inhale. May the ladies in our space.
Okay.
Yes.
Yes! Asante! This is beautiful.
For you, because you are so beautiful, and we make beautiful things for you.
Thank you.
You are welcome.
And so I just go over here?
This way.
Okay.
Fanya wewe mwenyewe anchelewa. Nini tu? Poa. Umenambia ngapi ngapi? 20 20. Mimi mwenyewe kanipa 10. Eh.
Basi wewe usimwambie kama nini, wewe mwambie tu.
Ah, naambia 10 sasa. Basi. Eh.
Hello.
Yeah. I sent it.
Hakuna Matata. Pale, pale.
Yambo.
Yambo.
Hello again. Hello. Hello again. Welcome to Zanzibar.
Asante, asante.
Ena kwa mani na upendo. Karibu ni Zanzibari, hakuna matata. Hakuna matata Zanzibari. Jambo.
Dakika 45 tu yote.
Oh. Oh. Pale pale.
Kuna matata. Jambo. Jambo bwana. Habari gani? Zore sana.
Ah.
Habari gani? Zore sana. Woo! Wageni.
Eh, poa.
Zanzibar yetu hakuna matata. Yapo 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 ndio. Atichoo.
Pale pale.
Hakuna matata.
Hey!
Imuni wageni hakuna matata.
Hey!
Zanzibar yetu poa hakuna
matata. Hakuna matata.
Karibu ni sana. Hakuna matata.
Woo! Asante, asante.
Karibu sana.
You're most welcome. Okay, how is it?
Great.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, have a seat.
Okay.
You all look like a queen, eh? She is so pretty.
Thank you. Asante, asante.
You're welcome.
Asante sana. Don't say apana, never smoking marijuana.
You are from US, huh?
Yes.
Oh, your name, please?
Zenzi.
Zenzi.
Mm-hmm. Zanzibar.
You are welcome,
Zanzibar. Okay. Okay, I'm going to say
something. Right, you are welcome, oh. Zanzibar.
All right, asante, asante, hukuna matata.
You're welcome.
Zanzibar!
Okay.
Na mie ba. Au video?
Video.
You take video?
Eh.
Video a picture.
Ah.
Afu ndoka nyo zile nyuza.
Leka leka.
Oh.
How is it?
Kola kuja malize.
Very good.
Very good.
You have finished your, huh?
Yes.
So right now, time to eat the flesh inside.
Oh, very good.
Mm-hmm.
Very sweet.
Ne pige pita mpaka uko mele. To remove the white stripes like this.
Mm-hmm.
After that, there is the seed inside. That's must remove it.
Okay.
Then you can eat this one, the fresh one.
Okay.
It is very very nice and sweet one.
With this piece right here, you want me to grab? Okay.
Remove the white one.
I'm removing all of this.
No. There is a seed inside.
Okay, my first time eating jackfruit.
Okay, you can tell me how is it?
Very sweet, like banana.
Yes, I told you it's like banana.
Mmm, almost like a mango too.
But yeah, yeah.
Mmm, it's really good. So what do you put this in?
This one?
Mm-hmm.
Baby.
If you were like cooking it with something?
No, there are some people that are vegetarian.
Mm-hmm.
They cook. They mix with the coconut milk. But in Zanzibar, we use like a fresh fruit. We don't cook.
Okay.
It's not good, not good while you cook it.
Baby.
So I just pulled up to my new hotel in the city. I'm so excited. They gave me some hibiscus tea, complimentary of the house. Abraham here, still hanging out with me. I wish I could keep him here. He's about to probably leave though. But I'm just finished checking in.
y'all, so I have to make this kind of quick. This is my room. First, okay, let me just say something. Y'all, I have been treated like a queen in Africa. They haven't treated me like this in the States. They upgraded my room here for free to a whole suite. It's a bungalow that sits right on the beach. Y'all, like, come on, come on. Oh, here's somebody coming. Hi, come on in. Hi.
How are you?
I'm doing good, how are you?
Fine, I'm just
all right, y'all, so this is the outside of my room. Beautiful. All right, it's time for me to go on this tour.
So, I just want to say welcome.
Thank you.
First, I would like to say welcome to Stone Town. So now we are going to Stone Town, Zanzibar. So after arriving there, I'm going to show you the merging between Stone Town and New Town. Zanzibar, we have a Stone Town and we have a New Town.
Okay.
Stone Town is very small than New Town. New Town is very big.
Yeah.
Like California. You're from America.
Yeah.
United States. Which city?
Virginia City.
So now into the Stone Town, we are going to see House of Wonders. After arriving there, I will tell you why we call House of Wonders.
Okay.
And also we are going to see the Freddie Mercury house. Also we are going to see the Old Fort, the first apartment to be constructed around the Stone Town.
Okay.
And also we are going to see the Darajan markets, the local markets.
Yes.
Tourists go there to buy something if they want.
Yes.
We call Darajan markets, special for food.
Uh-huh.
Freddie Mercury born here in Zanzibar.
Really?
Yeah, born here, really, according to the history. Born here in 1946, and he died in 1981.
So, Fred, familiar with his music, I actually looked into him recently.
So do I.
Yeah.
This street's like a 45 feet, like this.
Okay.
Stone towns, Arabs, they came to build their stone towns, they plant like this.
Yes.
Small neighborhood like this.
Okay.
Okay, I understand.
Yes.
So now you have a parents now still alive?
Yeah.
Oh, you living with them? Yes, sir.
No, I don't.
So here we are in the Joe's Corner. This is the Joe's Corner. This is the center for Stone Town.
Oh, okay.
The center for Stone Town. We call Joe's Corner. Why we call Joe's Corner? Joe's, when we say Joe's, two means. First Joe's, Buddhist. Because during that time there were Indian royal family, they were living inside.
Oh.
Sorry.
Monday morning. Today is Monday, November the 1st. Today is Tuesday. It is Tuesday. Good Tuesday morning. Today is Tuesday, November the 1st. Sorry, I'm trying to get myself together. Good morning. Hakuna Matata. No, thank you. I'm okay. Okay, getting ready to go on my tour. I'm about to be leaving soon, but I'm about to order some food. Hi. Hi. I would like to order the chicken and mango salad, please. Yes, please, with no cucumbers.
No problem. Only one?
Yes. Thank you.
No drinks?
I'm okay. I have water. I just cannot. Like the pool. And then they have a pool upstairs on this side. Alright. Just the architect for me. And earlier, I showed y'all my bedroom that they put me in. Y'all, look, this is my salad, and look, they made it look like a pineapple. That's so cute. So, this salad is very muy bueno. It's so good. Although, I don't see much lettuce in the salad. Play scary?
No.
I didn't know he was coming to get me.
Yes.
I'm about to get on one of these boats and go to Prison Island. Again, Jumbo.
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 Jumbo, September, say hello.
Okay.
And then Zuri means good.
Which?
Don't you say Zuri means good?
Zuri.
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 Am I saying it wrong?
Zuri.
Azuri.
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 Saying Zuri.
Azuri.
This is salad, food for turtles.
Oh, that's
you.
Yes, thank you.
One day, like so much to eat.
Okay.
Spinach and the watermelon you use.
Oh, yes. Oh, look at that. This is so huge.
You move when you're doing massage like this.
Yes.
Just move like this. They like so much massage. They move. This is 35 age.
How can you tell?
Yeah, first, some of them are writing. Some of them they do writing because we know according to the shape of the tortoise and according to their experience. Because some of them they have already dropped the numbers, so we know.
Oh wow! Aww.
Massage.
Yeah. Oh, hi.
Yeah,
my
problem.
He's
moving too.
Yes, I see.
This is a record video?
Uh-huh.
Is this a record?
Uh-huh, it's
recording. Okay. He doesn't teach? Maybe he's not hungry. Some of them, they
mango chip.
Oh, thank you.
French
fries.
Oh god.
Wow. 175 pounds?
Yeah, each. And the kilogram like this, 120 kilograms.
Wow.
The oldest one, 100 kilograms. That's 120 kilograms. And this 100 kilograms. 198.
Wow.
When you see the skin, it already shrinks.
Yes.
And it was the first tortoise to bring here. When he was arriving here, he was 75 age.
Already at 75 years old when he came here?
Yeah, when he was arriving here.
Wow.
When he was coming here, he was 75 years old.
You could,
now 180.
You can tell by the shell his age too.
Yeah, yeah. Because these shells, big parts. It's a big tree is coming down.
Oh.
And from that time, it started to remove the shells. Pole, pole. Because the first, the problem, it was a big tree.
Yes.
It's coming to beat him.
And the shells are so hard, too.
Yeah, so hard, the shell. In this weight or kilograms, 100 kilograms.
100 kilograms. So
very,
how?
Very heavy, very heavy.
How many pounds is that?
Pounds.
Like pounds?
Pounds, like money?
No, weight.
Weight.
Yes.
The pounds, almost 120.
Okay. Yeah. Wow, 150 slaves were kept in here?
Yeah, here. Yes. And some of them, they were clothing the chair. So, during this time, there were a lot of chain used to close the slaves.
Wow.
So now there's the only one as evidence. This chain used to close the slaves. Because this room, there is two kind of doors, this one and this one. Some of them, they were escaping. Usually this door to escape. Over there, behind this apartment, there's into the forest.
Oh.
There's a hill. The slaves, they were passing here because of the trees. To enter in the hills, in the caves.
Yes.
To run away, to escape. Into the forest. To come here to establish the prison. They were taking the slaves in Africa, East Africa. So, British and Arab, they were main participants who were selling the slaves.
I'm going to take a picture of this right here.
So during the night, the slaves, they were passing here up to the boat, which was waiting here to pick up the slaves to transport.
Wow.
Before arriving on the boat, the slaves, they were arriving here in the small showers, small washrooms to prepare. Then they leaving.
But
they
this is so a huge drop. So how were they?
No drops. The water's coming. Move.
Oh. Yeah.
Water mount like this up to behind this.
Wow, the water, the tide can get that high up?
Yeah, the high tide, the water is come up.
Because the tide is low right now.
Today is low tide. Yeah, when the high tide is coming.
Wow, that is high.
Yeah, very high tide. You cannot jump if the high tide.
Y'all, look at Abraham and I. We're kind of matching out here. Yeah. Huh?
How about...